Welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Sierra. I make videos all about life post-20s, travel content, just a lot of fun stuff. College, graduation, that awkward phase that we're all going through. If you're in your 20s, 30s, 40s, whatever. Just a lot of relatable content. So if you like that, please definitely subscribe. Give this video a like, a little thumbs up. And let's get right into this video. This video is all about Breckenridge, Colorado. I'm going to be talking about Breckenridge. I'm going to be talking about affordable ski clothes if you're going skiing. I know this video is being posted a little bit later, but I think the ski season ends like end of March, early April, and you need something really quick, I got you. And just my whole kind of take on my ski trip. And I'm wearing my Breckenridge, Colorado sweater that I got while I was there. So let's just get right into this video, guys. I went to Colorado last month in January. If you guys watch my other video, how I quit my corporate job, I actually signed up to go on their annual ski trip while I was still working there before I, like, obviously left. I paid my deposit. I was ready to go, and I obviously left. So I get a call from HR and they're like, hey, you know, we obviously know that you left, but you can still go. And I was like, I'm there. No problem whatsoever. So they still let me go because it was going to be cheaper to let me go versus having somebody else get my ticket, because they already bought my ticket in my name and everything. So I went with some really fun, well, the coworkers I was going with that I'm friends with, they were really excited. And I'm not going to talk about my experience as a group with them because I'm not associated with the company, and I don't even want to get into that, like, pure, like, just at all. So I'd rather not. But I will say it was a great time, and nobody was like shady towards me because I left. Everybody was like really, just had a really positive attitude about the trip in itself, and didn't really, you know, they wasn't really all about like, oh, Sierra, you left. Like, it wasn't like that. So it was a really fun time. Now, that's how I ended up going, and it was my first time snowboarding. So I'm going to break this video up in what I packed, the resort in itself, and Breckenridge, and give it a whole rating. So I packed everything, most of my stuff are from Amazon, and it's all linked below. So let's get right into that. Affordable ski clothes, base layers. Now, I got this as a duo pack on Amazon, and this is my base layer. Under this, I wore a sports bra. So this is one of my base layers. I got it in this color, as well as I got it in black. So those are my two base layers I got. If I snowboarded one day and then the other, I had two. I was only there for 3 days, by the way, guys. And I got these leggings. I got two of them, but the other one is dirty. So these are my leggings, and this is the brand name that I got. Everything is right now is in a large. Everything I ordered was large, by the way. I honestly could have sized down to a medium, but that's fine. So yeah, I got these in a large, and when I mean this duo was amazing. I fell so many times snowboarding. It was unbelievable. I thought I was gonna be soaking wet. By the time we got back to the room and took off everything, I was dry. This kept me very, very dry. So if you're worried, like if Amazon, like if you don't have wool, you'll get dry and sticky and sweaty, order these. I'm telling you, I felt very warm. It was in the snow. It was 10 degrees when we were snowboarding on the mountain. We woke up to -3. It was 10 when we went to the mountain, and I was warm. I was warm, but mind you, I'm sweating because it's hot, it's cold, you're doing a lot of stuff. When I took everything off, dry. Get these. I also got these socks. Where's the other one? Okay, I don't know. Oh, right here. I got these thermal socks. They're linked below too. They came in pairs of two. The other one's in my room. These are the ones I actually wore on the mountain, and I washed them, as you guys can see. But essential. When you get your snow boots, if you're renting, you probably want to go up a half size or a whole size because they're so thick and you want to be comfortable on the mountain in your snow boots. Like, your snow boots are going to be big, so you definitely want to be comfortable. So just keep, I would say, start with a half size, and then go up a foot if they are too tight. But yeah, these are my socks. They literally saved me. Guys, I fell so many times in the snow. It was ridiculous. But these are my socks. Now, I got snow goggles from Blenders. And it came in this really pretty case. And it has the snow goggles and your little cloth for it. And this is the case for it. These are the ones I wore on the mountain. And the fuchsia, because I like this because it matched my fuchsia pants. But I brought two. And this is the other one that hopefully I'll wear next year. I didn't wear these ones when I went. So yeah, those were a few of my things that I got. And also the last thing I want to show you guys is my hat. This hat is from Graciel, I think the name is. It's a black-owned business and it has a satin lining on the inside. I went snowboarding with my hair just like this. For you guys that don't know, I have clip-ons and sometimes I wear micro links. And I was so nervous that my hair was gonna get tangled or whatever. I was on the mountain and kept me all great. So, this is my hat. After my base layer, so my leggings and my pants, I just put on my ski pants. They're from Amazon too. I don't have my ski pants or my ski jacket to show you guys, but I didn't add any other layer. So, I just wanna let you guys know that. And that was just my choice. I chose not to add another layer. I personally don't think I needed it. I was hot as is. So, after my base layer, my socks, I went and put on my white ski jacket. And I'll put a picture so you guys can see how I looked. And then I put on my fuchsia pants, and that kept me very warm. I know some people usually put on a jacket before their ski jacket. I did buy a fleece jacket. It is from Amazon too. I just really wore that to like walk around the resort, not to go skiing. So again, everything is linked below as well. So that is my affordable wear. I believe the socks were $13.99. The leggings, the base layers were about $40, like 20 for each. Blenders, I got it for buy one, get one free on Black Friday, so that was 120. My hat, I got it for buy one, get one free too, $20. So in all, overall, I think I, and this is the estimate for my whole ski outfit, I would say under 300, which is very affordable. Because if you guys look at any other ski outfits, which are bait, like mind you, a lot of people tell you to wear wool, which you should, because like the wool is the best to wear when you're going skiing. Those leggings were like $50 to $75. The top, another $75. Then your whole suit is like $200. So I definitely saved like $400, I'm not gonna lie, by going on Amazon. And I was just as warm as anybody else out there. So that's my affordable wear for Amazon. Now, on to the resort. We stayed at Beaver Run Resort and it was beautiful. Also, guys, sorry if you can hear something. I'm pretty sure there's a plane going over. Sorry about that. But we stayed at Beaver Run Resort. It was beautiful. There are so many buildings, so it's very easy to get lost. It's huge. The only thing I didn't like about Beaver Run Resort was they were short-staffed. And I don't even like that I have to say that because I know we're in a pandemic. There's the Great Resignation going on, and that's just really a nuance. But they were really short-staffed. The food there wasn't that good. I'm just being honest. I didn't think the food at the resort was good, and they were short-staffed. So that made it really hard. The resort. Maids, they didn't really come and they didn't come clean the room or give us new towels or anything that we had requested. There's that. And again, I think they were again being short-staffed. So that was just my experience. That may not be everybody's experience. But my experience there was with the staff, it was like non-existent because they, no, like nobody came to help us. However, the resort itself was really, really nice. And the staff that we did interact with were really attentive and very helpful. I will say that. I do recommend getting your ski rentals early, like an hour and a half early. They only had two people working the ski rentals, and the line was outrageous. So I would get your ski rentals very, very early. And also, our instructor, he was phenomenal. Beautiful. He was just not beautiful, like in looks wise, but I mean, like overall, the whole ski lesson was just beautiful in itself. So, yeah, that's my only grudge with Beaver Run. But like I said, I know we're in a pandemic. I know there's other things, so don't come for me. Now let's talk about Breckenridge, the town. I thought I was in a Hallmark movie, guys. I'm gonna add some pictures and videos throughout this. I felt like I was in a Hallmark movie. It was like this cute little town. There's snow everywhere. You have the mountains in the background. There's all these little shops and bakeries. I was literally in love. I was like, because I've never seen anything like this ever. I'm from the East. I was in the South. I was in Florida for most of my life, here in New York, and now I'm here in New York. Like, I just didn't see anything like that in my entire life. It was breathtaking. We ate at a really nice restaurant that I do want to give them a shout out called Canteen. They did really good. That was probably the best food there. We also ate at a Mexican restaurant. I can't even remember the name. The Mexican restaurant and Canteen where we ate, they had pretty good. Their food was like the best from what we're eating in Colorado. So their food was really good. We went to a jewelry store, a consignment shop. It just was the whole town itself. Everybody was so friendly and nice. It really, really felt homey. But again, extremely short staff. And that's just worldwide, so I'm not gonna be like picky about it, but I'm just heads up, extremely short staff. But the whole town was, it was great. I really, really loved going around the town. And there's a million and one bars. Like, I'm not gonna lie, there's so many bars. You can bar hop all night. Just know the bars are small. So when you get there, you'll see it for yourself. They have the bar, their bars are pretty small, but there's so many bars. And they don't take reservations for restaurants. That's something I don't like because you guys know I'm a New Yorker now. I'm used to making a reservation and you get there. They do not take reservations. It's first come, first serve. My recommendation is when you get done with skiing, eat a little snack, shower, and leave like 6:30. There's a shuttle at the Beaver Run Resort that will take you into town. All you have to do, honestly, is call the number on the back of your card key. Say, hey, I'm outside of building wherever, building two, for example. A shuttle will come get you. The shuttle will drop you off wherever you want to go. And then when they pick you up at these little stations that are numbered. So you just call the back of the card again on your cell phone, say, hey, I'm at station 20 something, come pick me up. And they will, but leave early. Like, you need to be sitting and eating dinner for 7 o'clock. I'm gonna like for 7:30, I'm gonna be honest. Because if you leave at 7:30 to be there for like eight, like if you're going with a big group, you have no chance. No chance. You're gonna be standing up at a bar. Leave early. No reservations. So that's my tip for you guys. But overall, my rating for the whole 3-day trip, I give it an 8.5 out of 10. I had a fantastic time. I bust my ass snowboarding. Heads up, if you're not used to the mountains, altitude sickness is real. I'm gonna need you guys to pack a lot of water and Tylenol Extra Strength or Advil, whatever you prefer. I'm a Tylenol girl. I need Tylenol. The headache I had was so bad. My sinuses, I had nosebleed. Yeah, pack a Tylenol and drink lots and lots of water. But overall, I loved Breckenridge, Colorado. I can't wait to go back. When I go back, I'm not gonna lie, I probably won't ski or I'll do another lesson. But I like the after ski activities, my après-ski. I like being in the hot tub. I like being out on the town. That's That was like my thing. And doing all, and like drinking after, and like, for me, it's that like that camaraderie. What? Wow. Blah, blah. I can't. Sorry, guys. I can't even say what I want to say. It's that, you guys know what I'm trying to say. That feeling of everybody being around and with you is so, it's so fun after skiing. And that's what I really like. So I like the after ski stuff. I may do a lesson and then do all the after ski activities. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was a good breakdown on affordable ski clothes to get. I'm telling you, you cannot get a deal this good on Amazon. Anywhere else, it's very expensive. But I feel like if you're a skier and you're invested, you should invest, right? But if you're a beginner or it's your first time, my links, it's all on Amazon. So definitely go check it out and get yourself some affordable ski clothes. And wherever you're going skiing, even if it's not Breckenridge, Colorado, enjoy, have a great time, go in the hot tub, have a nice beer, enjoy the people you're with. And if you're alone, you'll make tons of friends because everybody's just hanging out, just chilling after they're going skiing. So enjoy and have so much fun, guys. And let me know in the comments if you guys are going skiing or where you guys are going. I want to know. So I will see you guys all later. Bye.